Okay. It is now 6:04 p.m., June 28th, 2021. I'm going to call the Somerset Conservation Commission to order. We are at the Somerset Public Library. This will be recorded and broadcast on SATV channel 15 and their YouTube channel. Roll call vote, or roll call order, please.
Karen Smigel, present.
Matt Talbot, present.
John Costa, present.
Bob Kamara, chair, present. And
Tim Turner, agent, present.
All right, thank you. Did everybody, did we get, did Bonnie distributed the minutes, right?
Oh, yep. You know what? I'm sorry.
Did you know?
That extra copy that I have over there, could you pass that down? I'll give that to Karen.
Sure.
I didn't see where she shut off.
You want? Okay, if I may?
Please.
So the first order of business was a continuation of the notice of intent.
Well, actually, I'm talking about the minutes.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, that's okay. So did everyone, they were distributed by Bonnie.
Right, yeah.
So did anybody have any updates, questions, concerns, errors, omissions?
No?
Okay. Hearing none, I will entertain a motion to approve the minutes of, June 24th? No. Last one.
14 days ago.
So June 14th?
Yeah.
The minutes of June 14th?
So moved.
I have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
The motion, pardon me.
Yeah.
But the motion should be to waive and accept waive the reading and accept the minutes of
the meeting of June 14th.
Yes.
Okay.
I would like to make a motion that we waive the reading of the minutes and accept the minutes as presented through email by Bonnie from June 14th.
Okay. Motion, do I have a second?
Second.
Second. Okay, any discussion? No, all in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed? All right, thank you. All right, sorry, go
ahead. Okay, no, sorry. Just, there's one more thing to that. I am not sure, but maybe just as the undecided question, I am not sure if you need to do a roll call vote for each vote. I know we never used to when we were live before, mm-hmm. but for planning board we have been. So like when you vote to accept the minutes, everybody says aye, but I'm just don't want to have any meeting law violations.
I mean, I think at this point with something like that, I think with when we were in Zoom, it made sense to do.
Yeah, I don't disagree. I just I'm being overly I guess.
Yep. No, that's fine. I think when it comes to
adhere to the procedures. That
yeah.
We should.
Yeah, and I think when, okay. when especially when it comes to the hearings.
Yeah.
I think I'm fine with that as well. So.
Do you want to do a roll call vote then?
Karen Smigel says aye.
Matt Talbot aye.
John Costa aye.
And Kamara says aye.
Huh? There you go. All right. I feel that sounds good.
Ready? Okay, sir.
Go ahead. Yep.
Okay, so there was a continuation for the notice of intent filed by Hyde Development, the Palmer Street project. The last time they were here, they were waiting to hear back from the planning board's engineer to see how it went with the punch list
okay.
and their review. So we, the planning board, has gotten the review back from Fuss and O'Neill, and they don't call themselves SciTech anymore. Civil and environmental consultants. They had not, at least as of tonight, been able to draw up the new plan reflecting any of the changes that Fuss and O'Neill made. But I'm sure that it might even be done by now, but this was as of last Thursday. This was from Dan Agia, and he was the rep that was here.
Mm-hmm.
For our discussion, I would like to update the commission with regards to this week's planning board hearing regarding the Palmer Street project. The board tabled the matter to the next hearing because we have not heard back from the peer reviewer. I know the commission approved the project conditionally, which we did, upon the applicant receiving planning board approval, so I figured I'd let you know. So we have not signed anything yet. This is because it was contingent on that, it's technically still open.
Yep.
So our next meeting is July 12th. So I think it would be in order to have somebody make a motion to continue this hearing to July 12th.
I thought there was an issue with July 12th.
Because that's the special election day?
Oh, that's
right?
That's right. That's right.
Okay. That's why we met today.
Today.
Because of next week.
Then the 19th.
Next week's the holiday and then.
It has to be the 19th. There's no other way around it.
Yeah, I mean, we don't traditionally do meetings on that. I mean, I don't think it would be a problem if we did, but I have no problem holding up.
On election day, I don't think it would be a problem either, but.
But I mean.
You know what? I don't want anybody to have to miss something because they wanted to go vote or whatever.
Yeah.
So.
That's fine. We can do it.
I had a couple.
Is it, just make sure you let Dan know.
Because we'd be down Bonnie too. Because Bonnie usually works the elections, so.
Yeah.
Something to keep in mind.
Yeah, good point. So, I mean, we can go with the 19th and just let Dan know if that becomes a problem, then he'll just let us know.
Yep, okay.
Okay.
I'll let him know.
Yep.
So that's, there's only a couple other things on here and we'll be done for the night.
Do we need a motion for that again?
Yes, it so needs to make a motion to continue.
All right, entertain a motion to continue the notice of intent filed by Hyde Development for the construction of the two single-family dwellings and appurtenances on Palmer Street, map D4, lots 23 and 46.
So moved.
I have a motion. Do I have a second?
A second, John Costa.
Second, okay. Roll call vote.
Karen Smigel, aye.
Matt Talbot, aye.
John Costa, aye.
And Bob Kinnear, aye.
Okay.
Thank you.
So, we need to choose a rep for Community Preservation Committee. Bob has been the rep for the last several years anyway. 3 years anyway?
Something like that.
So
I'm happy to continue, but if somebody really, really wants to do it, I'm more than happy to, you know. It's up to you.
I am the member at large on the committee. There's a lot to learn, and you know, it's kind of like what we were talking about before, when once you get onto something. For the 3 years I'll say that Bob's been on it, it's not that it shouldn't change hands, it's just, like I said, there's so much to learn. This particular kind of group, continuity is a good thing. I mean, don't get me wrong, faces do change from time to time. But in my opinion, if you have a member and things are going well and they come to every meeting and they participate, then they deserve a chance to be reappointed to it if they would like to be. But like Bob said, if somebody else wants to do it, I don't think he's gonna get in the way. And nor would I.
Well, how much time does it entail?
It doesn't entail much time. It's,
you know,
not.
I'm working crazy hours. You know.
Yeah,
I respectfully. Hey, you want it, so you know, it's like, I have plenty of stuff to do. And I agree, Tim, like, I'm sure, like, something like that, it is good to have the continuity and the knowledge and the public history behind what kind of projects you've looked at or want to continue on, so I totally support if you want to do it. If anybody else wants to do it, you go right ahead.
It's not something that meets on a regular basis. We have our annual, well, we just had it. No, we didn't.
No,
we were going to have it. We have an annual meeting coming up, and we'll have a meeting in October to determine eligibility for however many applications we get. Then we'll meet again end of January for the funding. And that's when we determine what projects are going to get funded and what is not going to. Sometimes that's a two-day meeting, and then we'll usually meet one more time before the town meeting. So it's not like it's all the time, but when we do meet, it can be.
It takes some time. But it's on the weekends, two-day meeting, or?
The meetings, no, they're not usually on the weekend.
We've done them.
Usually they're on Thursdays.
Yeah, either like
but
successive
it's in the
weeks.
Evening, though, right?
What's that?
It's in the evening.
We start at around 5, but it can go.
Yeah.
It can go.
Well, I mean, I might be interested in it if it's a few meetings a year. I mean, it all depends if anyone else wants it.
So I'm good. I have too much to do right now. So getting here on time is a chore.
I know, that's a problem, isn't it?
So.
Well, I'm fine. However, everybody wants to do it. Like I said, I'm happy to do it, but if somebody.
We can hold off till our next meeting when everybody's here. Maybe that would be more appropriate. We're missing three members right now. So I actually, I think that's a good idea.
Yeah, we can talk about it a little more.
You can think about it, and I think we get to the next meeting, I think that will be the time to do it, because we won't, still won't have met with CPA yet anyway, so.
Oh, yeah, so because we didn't have it last week, is it scheduled already or no?
July the 26th, it's a Monday. Tentatively, not.
Okay.
Not 100% in.
Well, that's right, because, so rec is going to vote tomorrow to, it's on the agenda. So rec is going to vote tomorrow to reappoint whoever wants to do it. Kelly O'Brien is currently the rep from rec. And then I think the selectman voted, is it Lauren is going to be the?
I think, but once they have the election, they're probably going to reorganize to some degree.
That's true.
And I mean, I'm the member at large, so I still need to be appointed by them.
Okay.
And then they're the park commissioners, so they'll have to decide who's going to.
Which one of them is going, okay.
Who's going to come into it.
So that's normally how they decide.
And we do already have, Tony Soares is not coming back.
Okay.
So Matt Aspen is going to be taking his place.
Oh, okay.
We have a new parks commissioner coming in, so there'll be two or three new faces. You know, so, yeah, when it changes, but we have had pretty much the same steady group for, at least since you've been on it. I've been on it since the start.
Yeah.
There's been a couple of changes, but.
All right. So, I mean, if there's not, but appreciate the interest, John. And, you know, if you've got any questions, we can.
I'll put it on the agenda then for our next meeting.
Okay.
Okay.
Awesome.
Okay. So the lining of the sewer lines. So in the area of Prospect, like to the west, down to Reed Street, the water and sewer department are relining the sewer lines. Maybe not relining, they're lining them. Okay. These are the old clay pipes. And what it is, it's a lot like when they did the pipeline across the river when
yep.
they relined it.
Yep.
It's like taking a sock and pulling it inside mm-hmm. out.
They fill in the tube with another tube.
It fills in the tube with another tube yep. and it extends
it's like
the life.
A plastic liner, like a Teflon or a polyethylene?
Yes, it's something to that effect.
It increases the speed and has less blockage. It's a good thing.
And if there is any damage to the clay pipe, it won't allow anything
it
to
leak. It won't let leak, yeah.
It's like a bladder almost. So that work has been going on. They had come across, so what they do is a series of manholes that nobody knows where they know where they are. None of us know where they are. They're all in the woods behind that area, that wooded area that goes down from like way behind the high school.
Yeah.
You need a metal detector.
Right down to Reed.
Probably.
So they know where they all are. They got them cleared out. And the work is done from the manhole. So as they get to each manhole, then they reline the next sewer line. So last week, unfortunately, they can tell when they're putting the lining in if the pipe is compromised in any way. So the pipe on one side had all collapsed, and more than likely it had been collapsed and probably leaking for quite a while. So they had to get in there. They had to widen a path, get in there with a machine to dig it out. They did it all one day, and then the next morning it was done. They just cut the section of pipe out, replaced it, and then moved on. I did call DEP, and because it was sewer work that is connected to a sewer treatment plant, I can't quote them verbatim. I don't know the whole regulation by heart. It was determined to be exempt.
Okay.
And it wasn't that big of a deal. They did not have to dewater anything. There's a brook that runs through there. Didn't affect the brook at all. There was a tree near the brook that was near where they thought they would have to dig, and that was a concern. The tree never got in the way. So they dug a trench about 20 feet long, about 8 feet deep. They cut the pipe out, put the new one in, and everything's back to normal.
Okay.
They filled the trench in with the same materials that they took out. They just pushed it over to the side. So I expect everything. There was no impact on anything.
Okay,
no.
That's interesting.
Well, those pipes,
it just was in. It was in there.
Those pipes are over 4 feet under the ground. I mean, you know, whatever they do, it's under. It's way low in the ground anyway.
Yep.
It doesn't freeze.
So it was done. The work is done, and no harm to anything. And I expect anything that did get a little flattened out, is going to bounce right back with the sun and the rain that we've had a couple of weeks. We don't even know they were there.
Yeah.
And, you know, so this, it's a very fluid thing that's happening fast. So when this happens, the water department gets a hold of me right away, and they are on a tight schedule to keep moving along. So that was why I got out there quickly and got a hold of DEP. I had a gut feeling it was going to be exempt anyway. Otherwise, we would have had to issue some kind of an emergency order, and then we'd have to have a hearing after the fact anyway, which to me is kind of like putting the cart before the horse. It's, everything was done, it was managed, it was supervised.
There was a leak, it was controlled right away.
What's that?
If there was a leak, it was controlled right away.
It was controlled right away, yep. So it's a good ending to the story that I haven't had to experience anything like that before, but it was I learned a lot.
It happened to me to one of my rental properties.
Really?
I went through that 30 years ago. I had to dig out two sections of pipe that collapsed and put in a new piece in the middle. It's a big job when you don't have a backhoe.
That's right.
Especially considering that.
They're doing a good job over there, so.
Well, thanks for the update. Actually, could you just let me know kind of where that is? I just want to take a look just to.
Oh,
just
certainly.
To see what they did.
If you want to walk out there Friday when you're off, I'll be happy to show you.
Okay.
Wear lousy shoes.
All right. Duly noted. All right. New business?
No, I don't have anything new other than the next meeting will be the 19th.
So what is this?
It should be a busier night, so okay. I'm going to reach out to everybody a little bit earlier, kind of like I need you to commit so we have a full board.
So the other handouts that you gave us today,
okay.
just
on the other hand, this is just something we are in the looking stages, okay? Somebody has the original. I don't know why these other copies I made came out black and white, but they don't do much.
Okay.
I'm sorry. I can email everybody the color copies tomorrow.
Okay.
So there's been some interest in reopening the town landing at the end of North Street. So if everybody
oh, that's
has a map.
The woman that spoke with us. She had some questions about that land. The North Street. There was somebody who had talked about one of our meetings.
A real long time ago.
No, this was it? Maybe it was a wreck. I think it was a.
Oh, it was no. It was wreck. And I think it was. Yeah. Wasn't
she wanted to know if it was the if we were the beach, if we had control over the beach.
Okay. Okay. Then that must have been what it was.
Yeah. So. Getting everything.
If everyone can look at the map. They can see where North Street, where the wide part of it, it ends and it narrows down and there's like a right of way that goes through. You see the word town landing, goes through down there and it has the marsh grass, the salt marsh line, the coastal barrier line. Do one of you guys have the original? The picture's being color. I don't know which one of you guys
no,
I gave
it to. Black and white.
I think I have black and white too.
The black and white.
Those are all black and white. Those copies down there?
Yeah.
Maybe they're on the copy.
Probably on the copier.
That's okay.
Anyway, there is, I don't know what kind of wetlands there are just getting down to the town landing. But I do know that there's an enormous amount of spartina down there.
Is this at all cleared or accessible?
Nothing is touched. Nothing's been touched.
So nothing. In other words, if
the only thing that the only thing that was touched was over here, where they came in for the new house. They knocked down that red shack.
Okay.
At the very bottom.
Yep.
Otherwise, the people that own this, where's this first lot on the bottom?
Yep.
They also own the second lot, and the town landing goes between them. So, I think there's some arrangement for the new homeowner over here to work something out with these people for the second lot to make this all one. So it'll be one lot with one owner, one lot with one owner.
Okay.
That doesn't answer anything.
So
as far as the landing goes.
So they don't have a cottage or a garage or a shed or anything sitting on that.
No.
That land.
Nope.
Okay.
It's just wooded, and then it goes. Once you get down to the water, it's got all the spartina. So if this particular spot was to be, you know, to be considered to have access to the water. There's several things that would need to be done. We would need to have, first of all, we need to have it flagged.
Well, that was what I was going to ask you.
At that point, there's no way we could do any clearing over here without some kind of hearing. I doubt very much that DEP is going to allow any of that spot tina to be cleared. So it would have to be some kind of elevated walkway to go over it and maybe have an area, like a meditational area or
like a
fishing
walk, right?
Or whatever. What's
yeah.
that?
Boardwalk.
Yeah.
Yeah. It could be done in such a way to let in enough light, but that's a lot more than just saying we'd like to open it up to public access.
So, right. Tim, who's bringing this up?
What?
Who's...
The selectmen are asking.
Just because?
There, I get maybe somebody had some interest in it and asked them, I don't know, but okay. I was just asked to bring it before you guys tonight.
Okay.
Just for any conversation and any ideas, you know, it'd have to be flagged. There'd have to be a hearing. If there is going to be some kind of elevated structure, you're probably looking at Chapter 91. Funding for something like that, it's not going to be cheap. You'd have to have some plans made up by somebody that's in that field to have the hearing, obviously. So I gave everybody, there was a list.
The remains of the former wood dock, is that when the recreation department used to have the docks out on the Taunton River? Or is that like an old dock?
I don't know. The existing dwelling that's there right now, they have a dock. They have a permitted dock that they came before us a long time ago for. So if there's any remains over there, they're probably like little stumps sticking out of the ground from some point in time. Mm-hmm. I mean, back in the day when there were no cars, there were access to the river, you know, all the way down Riverside Avenue.
At several locations.
And I thought there were more than this going back. This is going back to the early 90s when a few of the members thought we should start to consider reopening some of these access to the water. I can tell you right now when they did, this is not like, you know, 100 plus years ago. This is people's yards. And it's been sold down the line where people, you know, I don't know exactly what's in my deed. I know there's no easements. But now to tell somebody we'd like to put a sign in your yard saying that there's access to the water that they really don't have any fight about, I got to imagine that there's going to be some of these places that are probably not going to be too thrilled. Like right now, the bottom of Angus Street, the stairs are still there, the access is still there, been there probably 25 years, and that's a great spot, and I'm all in favor of keeping the stairs intact. They're going to need a little bit of attention this year, we already know that, but I think the highway department can take care of that. In that avenue, there's the access down there is extremely limited, because when you get to the bottom of the road, there's a guardrail, and to go over it, you're literally going to go over it. Grandview Avenue, I'm not sure of that one. I'm going to go out and look at all of these personally. I'm not sure of Grandview Avenue.
We actually go down there for water testing with my class.
Go where?
Grandview
Avenue?
We go
down on Grandview Avenue.
So whereabouts is that? Is that at the like on the opposite side of Riverside? The bottom
all
of Grandview?
The way down Grandview, across Riverside, straight down. We had a house come in front of us a couple years ago.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, well, I'll take a look at that.
So it's still accessible by...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's very open.
Okay.
Clark Street, I haven't been down there in a long time, so I'm not exactly sure how the road ends, but that would certainly be something of interest. See, another thing you got to consider is a lot of these areas don't have any parking.
Yeah, I'm just thinking that. Like,
so...
All these people have been, like, stay away from my land.
I know that there's an issue, like just let me go back to North Street, for example. The lane that the houses are on, because North Street officially goes down here, but you've got that lane that used to be the old railroad bed that comes through that has a lot of the houses that at one time were probably a summer cottage, but there are some people that live down there year round. And when they were getting the other lot that was sold prepared, the workers were parking their trucks in a lane, and I guess it was not a very welcome situation. So, you know, if everyone's gonna walk down, that would be fine, but I don't know how you can control that.
Well, let's see, you know.
But there are places on here.
Like Grandview looks like that's still pretty accessible with the road.
Clark Street, I gotta go take another look, I'm not sure. Sims Avenue, that's probably gonna be a lot like Clark as well as Old Colony. Sandy Point Road, I haven't been down there in so long, I'm gonna go, this whole list, I'm gonna go investigate.
But now, is that the part on Sandy Point where they have like private property or private lane or?
Sandy Point does become private at a certain end, but that does not mean that the easement for the access to the water is not still there. But going back to what I was saying, it's probably gonna raise a few eyebrows, like, what are you doing down here?
Yeah.
You know? I'm not looking to have anybody, you know, calling the cops on anybody or anything like that, just because they're walking down to the.
You know, like, I mean, in my opinion, even if we don't do anything with it, like officially, like, even just to get signage saying that right of way or to.
Yeah, well, there was some signage up.
Yeah.
The matter of fact, if you really wanna know what the signs used to look like, go down to the Angus Street stairway, because that's the original sign that was there. The commission paid for them, and Charlie Schofield was the highway superintendent, he ordered them and had them made up, and he put them in, and we paid for it out of our wetland fee account. So that is an original sign. I think we can do better.
Yeah.
You know, there's been a lot of technology since then.
Well, I mean,
so it would certainly be something that's PVC, and certainly be something that we could put some color into.
Yeah.
You know? Well, we just spent time on the dotted line, so.
Let's just figure out.
We've got some of these.
Where we wanna go with this. Some of them may not be doable.
Mm-hmm.
The town beach at the foot of Pratt Avenue, I don't know if everybody knows where that is. If you knew where Pat Haddad used to live, it's that plot right next to hers. They have parking. It is way overgrown with spotina and everything else because it just has not been attended to. But they have parking, keyword.
Well, see, Sandy Point looks like there's still something. Again, I don't know what the, you know, where private access is versus public access.
Right. So that's something to consider.
I mean, if nothing else, I mean, you know, having a census sort of taken of the of that property isn't a bad thing to start. And then if you know, we decide it makes
we can sense, I think we can weed out the ones that probably, you know, are just not gonna work.
So Tim, have the selectmen requested more public access on each of these locations?
They've asked me to investigate each one of these locations to determine if we have any, you know, reasonable public access that we can still reuse. The town beach off of South Street, I don't know. I'm gonna assume it's probably the other side of where Pierce's Beach is. I don't know, but I think I can do some asking around and find out where that is. There's already plenty of access down there between the beach and the bluffs and everything else. So, you know, that might not be something that we might be better off putting our time into one of the other ones. The foot of North Street, which we just went through.
Yeah.
And Ocean Boulevard, which is off of Lees River, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And that goes all the way down. That may be something that could work because the town owns some land down there that could be used for a parking area.
Mm-hmm.
Some improvements would have to be made because it's kind of a pretty good incline getting down to the water and coming back up. But there are trails, and I know that people still use them.
Yep. Yeah, I remember in high school we went down there.
Is that what they used to call Belozo's Beach?
I just had to kind of clarify my brain. Going back to the foot of North Street, this location. So the selectmen asked for us to look at each of these possible public access points. Now, if this were to be developed, this sounds like there'd be a major, you know, a major project to do that.
It would be a project. Yep.
And this may not have anything to do with it, but the Totten River being a wild and scenic designation, does that have any...
Yes.
Anything to do with the development of these things? Good, bad, could we get grants?
It depends. There may be grants. They may try to get you to find another project. I haven't gotten nearly that far yet, so...
Okay.
Well, I mean, you know... But yes, the answer to that generically is yes.
So, yeah, so I have no problem taking a look if you want to, we can go and scope some of these out and see at least initially if some of them, you know, pick a couple that might make sense where the public access. For instance, you know, looking at Ocean Boulevard, that kind of ends, and that's got that little sort of beach area landing, so that's a possible spot. Again, I've been down there for a few years, so I'm not quite sure what that stretch of road looks like at this point, but...
So is that the first step, is to go out and just survey everything and take some pictures?
Yeah, I'll go out and I'll take a look, I'll take some pictures, and we can go from there and we can...
If you want to get together as a group, maybe on time, I can help out.
If we're going to do an onsite, we need to post it.
Yeah.
And that's not a problem either, but like say we decide we're going to pick a Saturday and let's go look at all of them, spend a couple hours, then we can do that, but I just need to know 48 hours ahead of time.
Okay. All right. Well, let's talk about this. Maybe we can at least take an initial look in the next couple weeks.
If anybody wants to, between now and our next meeting.
Go down to...
If you want to take a ride down and see if you can find what we're looking for here.
Just bring your...
That'd be fine.
Just bring your conservation card in case somebody sees what the heck you're doing down. I had a couple of people in the past gasp. So
I still do.
Yeah, it's always nice to have. But yeah, so if we take a look in the next couple of weeks and maybe on the next meeting, if we can squeeze something in just to say, hey, you know, there are a few of these that might make sense to consider, increasing public access. I think that'd be great.
I mean, wouldn't it be important to increase public access on all of them so you're not dealing with squatting, or is that not an issue?
I think we really have to kind of see what's in...
That is actually a huge issue.
Well, the right-of-way exists though, still, right?
Oh, they're there. Mm-hmm. It just might not be, it's just probably not a sign, but they're still there.
So unless someone's got some proof that they've been squatting there over 20 years and we let them...
Oh, no, I misunderstood you. When you were talking about squatting, I thought you meant
about
people like living in these areas.
Or
like,
using it.
There's a little bit of that going on, believe it or not. Tents and fishing and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So that's what I thought you meant.
That's what I thought. What do you mean, squatting?
I meant what John was thinking too.
Like you've been,
you know, like
so long.
Even with this here, you know, like how long has... You know,
like squatter
people
springs.
Hey, I just grew up near the water, so I know how those games are played. But
if it's a public right of way, I don't think you can lose it very easily because it's still a right of way.
It's just that sometimes without a sign, it's an effort of intimidation. You know, like that's all.
Yeah,
we'll take a look at them. I know we'll make the best choices.
Yeah,
and
again,
because it's like you said before, you know, some people have bought property not knowing that it was there. Well, I mean...
Oh, shame on them.
Yeah.
You're right.
It's not what title insurance is about.
That's called disclosure. I mean, it's...
My property had a storm drain easement on it when I bought it. It was made very clear to me. And when I bought it, I knew it was there. Mm-hmm. You know, they should know.
And we're not likely to see the New York New Haven Railroad come through anytime soon.
No.
So that right away. So that's good. All right, well, great. So, yeah, so if anybody wants to take a look, that might be something for us to do, too. Check that out. So that was under here. New old business, anything outstanding? And then the commission.
Did everybody get their stipend? Did you guys?
Yes,
I
showed up.
All right. I forgot to check. I got a check.
You had a check?
No, I said I've got a check. I haven't looked.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I'm going to go direct to you.
Yeah, I did direct deposit.
It goes direct deposit.
I did direct deposit. I thought we had to go direct deposit, no?
We did.
It does have to.
Yeah, it was a while back, right? You went to direct deposit.
Yeah.
Does it come up as town of Somerset?
It does.
Yes.
Yeah. I just have to go through because I get direct deposit.
Does your check from where come up as town of Somerset?
Yeah.
So, like, mine does too. And when I get the planning board stipend, they just put it right in my check. It doesn't, I don't get like a separate entry for it. It's just, my check that week will be whatever the $200 more or whatever it is.
Yeah, but with school department, you might, it might be a different, yeah, that might be a different pot that they take it from.
Well, take a look, let me know if there's a problem.
Will do. Sure, I got it.
So we don't have any public input. So if, does any of the commissioners have anything they'd like to add? No? Okay. Then I will entertain a motion to adjourn at 6:39 PM.
So moved.
So moved?
Second.
Second, all right. We'll do a roll call vote.
Karen Spiegel, aye.
Ed Talbot, aye.
John Costa, aye.
And Bob Kamara, aye. Thank you, sir.